Hello viewers, I'm here at the offices of Eris Properties Ghana Limited to talk to the development manager Nana Abba Debi on the benefits one can enjoy staying in sustainable buildings and to get a little insight into the success story of Eris Properties.
Welcome to Property Express Live, television and online streaming service that gathers creation's largest mind and most forceful decision makers in the property industry. Our dedicated journalists present to our audience exclusive on-stage interviews, stimulating presentations, and lively panel debate aired on multiple content platforms. The team provides cutting-edge insight, unique personalities, and peer audience engagement that have the power to transform property and sustainable investment, finance, business, and culture in the property world. Stay tuned.
Hello, Nana. How are you doing?
I'm doing well, Eric.
Yes.
Welcome to my office.
Beautiful place you have here.
Thank you.
Good. Well, I don't want to waste my time, you know, hanging around in there. I just want you to give me a little background into Eris Properties.
Okay, so Eris Properties Ghana Limited is a subsidiary of a larger group, property development group called Eris Property Group, that is based in South Africa. So our parent company is based in South Africa.
Right.
And Eris Property came about because of the fact that the macroeconomic factors in Ghana was doing well, and investors were looking to, you know, enjoy that kind of returns for markets like this. And basically also as a market, we had organizations that needed grade A offices and basically grade A commercial properties like Accra Mall, you know, all the,
right,
the commercial developments that's springing up all over Accra. So that's what really necessitated a move into this market.
Oh, okay. And how long has that been?
So Eris has been around for close to 6 years now.
Yes. Okay. Well, the building industry is rapidly developing new technology to manage emissions,
yes,
and improve energy efficiency and water management, while also lowering operational costs. Can you share with us how Eris Properties' sustainable building impact on operational costs and maintenance as compared to traditional ones?
Okay, so I would want to make mention that Eris has a deliberate sustainable policy where, in as much as possible, when we are designing our buildings from scratch, we have our goals or our developments to align to being water efficient, being energy efficient, having at the back of our minds that we don't only want to produce a commercially viable, but we want to also produce an environmentally friendly building. So when you take, for example, our two office projects, that's VP5 and SUTA, we've adopted a number of technologies when it comes to environmental issues. So for example, in our buildings, we have smart building management systems. For example, the occupancy sensors where within a particular floor, we have sensors that make sure that after some number of minutes, when there's no motion within that space, the lights would automatically go off and the air conditioners too would automatically go off within that space. And this is what it means for the tenant. So basically you have lower, you know, call it utility bills.
Right.
Because at the end of the day, let's say a typical old building, if you leave the air conditioning on and you go out of the building, the air conditioning will be on till you come back. But in this building, the smart building management systems that we have in place would automatically put the air conditioners off and the lighting is off within that space, which saves you ultimately in terms of utility bills.
Interesting. Yes. Interesting. That's right. Okay. So, kindly walk us through Eris Properties' resource efficiency and sustainable buildings as understood as a broad concept aiming to reduce resource use and limit environmental impacts from buildings throughout their life cycle?
Okay, that's a good question. So basically, as I mentioned earlier, we have a very strict policy when it comes to sustainability. And I need to mention that Aries Ghana particularly is backed by a fund called Momentum African Real Estate Fund that makes sure that every development that we are undertaking or we are looking at complies with the IFC performance standards or the EDGE certification standards. And what it does is that it breaks it down into energy, water, and sewage treatments, using recyclable material that can be recycled. And what happens is that at the beginning of design, our design team or the architect keeps in mind all these standards,
right,
and make sure that, for example, in designing the building, would allow natural ventilation in as much as possible. When it comes to the mechanical, they would use as much as very low carbon emission machines or low carbon emission systems that at the end of the day would have a positive effect on the building. Another point that I wanted to raise was the fact that when it comes to sewage treatment, for example,
right,
make sure that we treat the effluents.
Okay.
And if it's possible, use the water that is recycled for the landscaping, for gardening purposes. And also the treated effluents also means that you don't have toxic substances moving from your building into the main municipal treatment system.
So basically nothing go to waste.
Yes, it's a deliberate effort, and at the end of the day we are very keen on it. Our directors and our board of directors steer this whole company and make sure that operationally we incorporate all these things whenever we are designing.
Wonderful, wonderful, yeah. Wonderful. Oh, that's great then. Right. Okay, the buildings and construction sector in Ghana are a major source of greenhouse gas emissions.
Yeah.
What role can government and other key stakeholders play to step up their commitment to cutting down emissions by 80%?
Okay, I think that my personal take on that is that government is already doing that. They've started doing that, engaging us as industry players. For example, the kind of air conditioners that you would use in terms of carbon emissions needs to be to a certain standard. And even by the fact that you go to EPA for certification would mean that they would tick all the boxes when it comes to carbon emission. I think another good thing that is happening in the country right now is the involvement of IFC, the EDGE certification program, and its involvement with government to offer some bit of training, particularly to our practitioners. So by that, what I mean is the architects, project managers, just to be conscious of carbon emissions as well as environmental and social factors whenever they are designing, you know, a building. So I think it's something that is being taken very serious and being, you know, run by the Environmental Protection Agency. But at the same time, we have private players like ourselves, and, you know, making sure that whenever we deliver a project, it is sustainably, it has positive sustainable impact on the environment.
So you take pains to do this designing?
Yes, we just don't design. So for example, let me give you an example. We are currently looking at a design in airport or a commercial building.
Right.
And one of the things that we are doing is, if you look around the city right now, a lot of people are incorporating aluminium cladding on all over the building. Now what aluminium cladding does is that it doesn't allow a lot of air into the space. So you have typical buildings using aluminium and cladding at the same time using glazing. So what it means is that you need to run your air conditioners basically at 100% throughout the whole day.
Mm-hmm.
Now in this new design that we are doing in Roman Ridge, what we are doing now is we are using a perforated aluminium cladding. So what it means is that because of the perforations, it allows air to pass through, the natural air,
right,
to pass through the perforations. Mm. We are using the window sizes in that design is from call it floor to ceiling, so basically something that you can open to allow those natural air to pass through the aluminium clad, perforated aluminium cladding to come into the room. So that's a deliberate thing that we have looked at, because at the end of the day, we want to make sure that that building is sustainable and it's environmental friendly at the end of the day.
Environmental friendly, wouldn't there be dust entering those stuff?
I mean, somebody would say dust, but within the immediate environment of the building, that's why we've incorporated green landscaping.
Mm.
So it's not in an area where it's dusty, it's basically in an area that is well planned, but the landscaping would also sort of absorb some of the dust before it does get into.
Right. Thank you.
Okay.
Well, green buildings do not only reduce or eliminate negative impacts on the environment by using less water, energy, or natural resources, they can, in many cases, have a positive impact on the environment. Can you walk us through how Eris Properties' sustainable building protects biodiversity and ecosystems?
Okay, so we don't have that example here in Ghana, but I will just relate to what we've been able to do in South Africa.
Right, okay.
So when it comes to protecting biodiversity, we had a project where the space that or the land that we were going to use needed some endangered species to be relocated. And what we did was that we had to painstakingly make sure those endangered species were relocated safely. But not only did we do that, we went an extra mile of creating a natural habitat for those endangered species when we finished the development.
Right.
So even though we had disturbed the ecosystem for, you know, to put up that mall, we still were mindful to create some sort of natural habitat to allow us bring these natural endangered species back into a natural environment. So that's some of the, and another example, we try to avoid tree cutting as much as possible.
Okay.
So we would only fall trees that needs to go.
Okay.
We would incorporate in the architecture, the design, you know, and the trees as much as possible.
Mm.
So if, let's say, for SU, for example, we reserved or we just deliberately did not touch a lot of
trees.
These trees that have been existing for close to 100 years, we design around them, and at the end of the day, we try as much as possible to avoid cutting down of trees unless it's very, very necessary. And even if we cut it down, we make a deliberate effort of replanting trees.
Okay.
When we are done with
when the space is available.
Exactly.
In there. Okay.
Exactly.
Good. Now take us through some Eris Properties materials, mostly and widely used for sustainable architecture, and how it can help lower cost and lead to long-term cost efficiency.
Okay. So the first example is this aluminium perforated.
Right, that you just spoke about, yes.
And another thing is we also considering solar energy basically in our building designs. So traditionally, when you go into a typical office, and even at UP5 and SU, we have a standby generator, but what we've realized is that these standby generators add to carbon emissions, basically, because they are mostly powered by diesel.
Mm-hmm.
So what, as a company, we've decided to have a mix of solar and a mix of this generator, and the generators would only be used in conditions where, let's say, the lights have gone off or the power has gone off for a long period of time and you needed to add up. But the solar would basically be used for the lightning, for, you know, things that do not involve a lot of power consumption. So that if, let's say, in UP5 place, the power has gone off for just 30 minutes, you don't have to have the generator kicking in to add carbon emissions. Solar will automatically kick in and then have, you know, use solar to light up, you know, and the areas.
The area,
to be light up.
Yes.
So
that's
those
cool.
are some of the materials. We are also considering treated concrete slabs as well in our development. And I need to mention that one of the things that we do whenever we go to a site and we are doing demolition.
Mm-hmm.
So let's say we go to a site that has an existing old building.
Mm-hmm.
We try to save most of the materials that we've demolished and make sure that the
ones that can be reused,
the one that needs to be recycled, we take
recycle.
It to recycle plant for it to be recycled. So that is some of the things that we are, you know, deliberately incorporating in our operations to get things done. Yes.
You try as much as possible to make sure nothing goes to waste.
Yes.
That's good. That's good. That's good. Okay, well, now, what other infrastructure do you usually add to your development that makes it unique amongst other developers?
Okay, so I think that one of the key things I want to talk about when it comes to that, the fact that is that our developments are uniquely designed. Number one, like I said, it has sustainable principles at the back of the mind. Mm-hmm. We try as much as possible to adopt large floor plates, and what the large floor plates allows is that it allows you to suit it to your company's, the operations of your company's organizations. So we don't limit you. You come into the space, you have the open space, and you can plan the space on how you operate as an organization. The third key thing is that both our developments have ample parking. So right. You would find a number of times a very beautiful redesigned commercial building in Accra, but you realize that when you go outside, there are cars parked all over. But that's not the situation with 335 Place and Eschuta. We have ample parking, structured parking, where you come in, you drive up the structured parking, you park, and you go through the lift lobby into the office space. So there's no point in time where a client will come and be stranded, because the client would have to circle.
So in actual fact, there are parking lots in all the floors.
Yes. So 335 Place is 12 floors. Out of the 12 floors, 5 of the floors are structured parking.
Whoa.
That's how serious we are when it comes to, and this is one of the key things that makes our building very investor friendly.
Okay.
So any investor in the world comes in and sees that, well, this is a typical grade A commercial asset that we can look at. So those are some of the unique things that, at the back of all this, we have a very solid facility management team also running these two developments. In
Accra. That's good. Now, you said you've been here for quite 6 years now.
Yes,
okay.
Yes.
Now, any major challenges that you've faced when you took up this office as a development manager?
I think, well, I'll call them stepping stones,
mm-hmm.
basically. And it's been a very interesting learning curve,
mm-hmm.
where you are basically working with international partners, number one.
Right.
But number two, the real estate industry in Ghana has gone through a lot of cycles,
mm-hmm.
where we entered at the peak of the market, where everything was macroeconomic-wise, everything was booming. We had international organizations coming in, and some of these in the international organization do not compromise standards. So it means that even if they come to Ghana, they still want to sit in a space like they would sit in the state, or they would sit anywhere. And at the end of the day, it's thrown a lot of experience my way, basically, in the sense that you have the opportunity to engage these tenants, you have the opportunity to engage investors basically on a project, letting them understand. I think one of the critical challenges that stepping stone, I would call it, that we've experienced is the fact that we had COVID also slapping us in the face about 2 years ago,
mm-hmm.
where we had some of the tenants, you know, mostly working from home, and you needed to rethink the business to how you can get these tenants back to the office. So it's been a good journey with a lot of, you know, and things that we navigate through day in and day out, and I don't regret it in rejoining Aries Ghana.
That's nice. Now I want to ask you one last question. Would you like it? Should Aries Properties be awarded in a forthcoming Ghana Property Awards?
Definitely.
I know you can't wait.
Yes,
can't wait for that.
We don't think we have any competitors yet when it comes to our design, and it's something that we we are very proud of and we are very mindful of. And we know that at any point in time, when you talk about sustainable commercial buildings in Ghana, there's no way you can eliminate Aries properties as an option. Yeah.
We're praying that someone nominates you so we give you that award. You are very good.
Thank you. I
you know what you are doing.
I look forward to it.
Yeah. No, thank
you. Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. You are very good.
Thank you.
Viewers, you just heard me talking to Nana Abadebi, Development Manager of Aries Properties Ghana Limited. And I'm sure that you really enjoyed the talk we had. And like she said, she can't wait to take her award this year at the Ghana Property Awards. Thank you. I'm your host, Eric Ashi II.